Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to measure the pH of any kind of chemical using pH paper. For the experiment, we're going to need pH paper. And it usually comes in a small container with a scale that is printed on its side. We're also going to use a white piece of paper, and this is just to help us more clearly identify the colors. For the measurements, we're going to use some glass stir rods, and you can use just one, but just be mindful that you will have to clean it and dry it between samples. For household chemicals, I'm going to use lemon juice, and I transferred some of it in a small cup already. I will be using vinegar, and I transferred some in a cup already. And I will be using baking soda that I added into a small cup, and then I added water to it to make a saturated solution. And finally, I am going to need some deionized water to clean my glass stirring rod in between measurements. So let's get started. The first thing to do is extract the pH paper. And for each measurement, you really don't need a whole strip, but you can use the whole strip. For the first measurement, I'm going to take my glass stirring rod, dip it in the lemon juice, extract it, and then place one dot on the pH paper. And then I can take my pH scale, put it next to it, and I can find which color is most similar to the color response that I got by adding the drop of lemon juice. In this case, it appears that the pH of lemon juice is about 2. For the next measurement, I am going to use my vinegar, and I am switching between glass stirring rods, but you could just take your stirring rod, dip it in water, dry it, and move on to the next experiment. So I will dip my stirring rod into the vinegar, place it on the pH paper, and it gives me a color response. I will compare that color response to the scale that is indicated on the pH chart. And it appears to be closer to 3, but somewhere between a pH of 2 and 3. For my final measurement, I am going to demonstrate how to clean and dry our glass stirring rod. Clean it. Take a paper towel and dry it. And then we bring in our baking soda solution. We dip the stirring rod in there and then place a drop on the pH paper. Now we wait a little and then we compare the color response to the scale. And in this case, we see that the green color that was elicited is most similar to the pH of 8 on the paper. It may be between 8 and 9, but it is at least 8. We can practice the same method and determine the pH of a variety of other chemicals. Just keep in mind that between measurements, you will need to clean and dry your stirring rods. Or if you choose to, you can always switch to a pipette, as long as you remember to clean and dry your pipette in between your measurements.